Yeah, I'm in the mood to ruin some childhoods today. Let me tell ya, you remember these luscious popsicles from your childhood? Remember how you used to yank them with your teeth and you try to get them open and it would take you 10 minutes, 20 minutes, or you never even get it open? You'd have to go inside while all your friends were outside having a good time and you had to embarrass yourself to your parents and be like, "What is it?" Or you would tell them to open it and then they'd be embarrassing themselves. They try to do the same thing, wouldn't work for them. They'd go and get the scissors. And then at that point, it's just a catastrophe. Well, let me show you what I learned today. Let me get another popsicle. This one's fresh out of the freezer. Watch this. Oh, it actually worked. I didn't think it was gonna work, oh my god! Pina colada. All right, now that you hate me, 1/5 of One Direction dropped yesterday, and I'm kinda trying to hear it. I have never sat down and listened to a Niall Horan album before. I know his hits, Heartbreak Weather, and This Town, and Slow Hands, which are all bops, by the way. I don't know why I've never sat down and done this before. And then the singles for this album, Heaven and Meltdown. Both songs are a good time, and I gotta say, I think Niall might be my favorite One Direction member. He's a funny guy, he's a good looking guy, he's got a good voice. He's got good songs. The show, track number one, Heaven. Here we go. Woo-wee! I don't think I've ever listened to this song with headphones before. That ad lib right there sounded like my mom calling from upstairs and I got scared for a minute because it's 2:33 in the morning. And you and me go up in flames. I can't hit that note. It is 10 seconds shorter than the Big Time Rush album. What is up with his ad-libs and background noise? I thought that was a fire alarm. And even if I lie, I can't really tell if I hit that because I'm wearing headphones, so I don't even hear myself right now. This song doesn't reinvent the wheel, but it's just good. I literally could not imagine any other pop star singing this song. I had like 3 jump scares during that song. One of the background noises sounded like a fire alarm, which is really weird because I don't have a fire alarm in this house. And then I could have sworn in like the second chorus, I heard my mom screaming at me from upstairs. Holy crap, I am just traumatized. That song's like the definition of an 8 out of 10. Next track, If You Leave Me, Let's Go. I like these horns. Oh, this reminds me of something. I swear I've heard that exact bass line before. Yeah, that's a hit. I'm not saying it's any better than Heaven. Out of the non-singles on this album, I cannot see a song being more perfect for the radio than that song. Whenever he was saying leave me in the song, like, it was like interesting mixing because it was like way in the distance. I would say that song is about as good as Heaven, so I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10 as well. Next down is the second single for the album, Meltdown, which I would assume is the shortest song on the album, which I don't really know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Ooh, I like the. What was that? It was like, whoa! That was weird. This is a really catchy chorus. I remember it. Woo! Ooh, he waited with the drums. There they are. Okay, that was cool. I like that. That wasn't in the first verse. Ooh, I love that. I remember that too. Yes, that is good stuff. He keeps going with it too. Oh my god, that is a very dense bridge. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think I've heard that song with headphones before either. I'd only heard that song like a few times before listening to this album today. That was awesome, dude. Like, that is probably just as good as Heaven, if not better. I remember like kind of not really liking, that's why I only listened to it a few times, but with headphones, that song hits. I mean, dude, there were like tons of things going on in the bridge. I was just talking about the vocal effect, that was cool. In the second half of the bridge, there was like a clarinet or something. I don't know, I couldn't even tell. I was so distracted by everything else going on in the bridge. But yeah, that's a good song. All right, so first 3 songs are all 8 out of 10s for me, which is really good. Okay, next up is Never Grow Up, and it's 3.5 minutes long. Based off of the title of the song, I'm gonna assume there's gonna be an acoustic guitar and he's going to be singing his lungs out.
Wrong.
I What in the adore you? He's got a really soothing voice. I like the piano. Ooh, the synth! Dude, I'm not gonna lie, I haven't been paying attention to lyrics at all. God, that's such an Irish line. I'm gonna be honest, I think like the last 45 seconds of that song or so was honestly probably my least favorite part of the song, and normally like I go crazy for a bridge, I go crazy for that last chorus, and I was kind of hoping he was gonna do something a little more interesting with the end of that song. I like that song though. My man's getting inspiration from Harry Styles. That's adorable. That was probably my least favorite song so far. My prediction was miserable. I said it was gonna be an acoustic guitar song. I'll give it a 7 out of 10. It could grow on me, or it could never grow up. So the next song, track number 5, is The Show, which is the title track. It's a wonderful melody. Oh man. Oh wow, the orchestra is going hard. I love this chorus. Oh man, I got chills. What a great song, what the heck? I could give him props for an hour on the song itself. For now, I'm gonna give that man props for making that the name of the album, because there's no way there's a better song on this album than that. Fair play, Niall. If One Direction doesn't ever get back together, blame Niall. It's because he's having this solo career. 9.5 out of 10. That definitely tops the 8 out of 10s I've been handing out the entire time. That's gonna go in like my top playlist. I'm not even kidding. This album so far has been pretty freaking stellar. You Could Start a Cult is definitely an acoustic guitar song. I am preparing myself to cry. If I don't cry, I'm going to be severely disappointed, Niall. All right, track number 6, You Could Start a Cult. Simp. A harmonica solo and a Niall song? I gotta stop it, dude. I gotta stop it. Okay, this man is doing a little bit of everything with this album. I mean, a harmonica solo. Niall Cash. Just a simple song. Doesn't need to be anything more, though. What is gonna happen for the next 30 seconds? Oh. The fandom is gonna eat You Could Start a Cult up. That ending was awesome. The harmonica solo was awesome. There were sweet melodies in the chorus. The way he was singing, like the tone he was singing, you could tell he's felt this way, and he's felt this way recently. I called him a simp jokingly, but he's basically saying this girl could do whatever she wants and he would still be crazy about her. Or guy, I can assume his sexuality. You Could Start a Cult and The Show back to back. I mean, he's trying to kill his fans, but I think I'm gonna give it 8.5, because I think I prefer, you know, a pretty little song like that to upbeat bangers like Meltdown and Heaven. Track number 7, Save My Life. That is not what I expected. Okay. Wow, okay. Feeling a little Conan Gray here. Feels like a 1975 song. 100%. Oh my god. I'm liking this album, dude. Niall will just randomly put me in church at the most random parts of songs. There's a song on the new 1975 album that is like exactly like this. I can't remember what it is though. I think it's I'm in Love with You, but I'm not 100% sure. Oh my god. A little sax solo? This happened on the Big Time Rush album too, so I'm not even surprised at this point. Love what's going on in my right ear. I just feel like other Niall albums aren't like this at all. And I've never listened to another Niall album before in my life. Like, I wouldn't say we've gotten better with every song, because there was a couple songs here and there that were still good, but I didn't like as much as I like songs like The Show, You Could Start a Cult, whatever the frick Save My Life was. Every instrument in human history was on that song. This is not a great thing to say, but there's not really a lot of room for Niall to screw this up at this point. We got 3 songs left. I'm gonna give that song like an 8.2. Track number 8. On a Night Like Tonight. Sounds like the beginning of a Gnarls Barkley song. I swear to God, I've heard that exact riff before. I love a good Nile breakdown. There's one in every song. Bridge time? Oh, he's screaming at me. Honestly, I think my favorite part of this album, it's been a problem for me with a lot of albums this year. Not a single song on this album has dragged. And a perfect example of an album that did that this year was the Across the Spider-Verse soundtrack. Holy crap, there were some good songs on that album, but they were dragged like 5 minutes too long, and then they were just completely ruined. I mean, don't kill me. Not that it shouldn't have been Harry, but it should have been Niall just as much as it should have been Harry. So I'm gonna give On a Night Like Tonight 8.7. Next song is Science, 2 minutes and 45 seconds long. I'm assuming we're getting another upbeat banger, and then we're gonna top off the album with a ballad.
Wrong.
My prediction may have been horrible. Can you feel what's beneath? He's gonna sing me to sleep. Is it stone cold under? And I don't mean that in a bad way, like a lullaby. He's singing in this song more than he is singing in any other song, I think. I've got nothing against that song. Science is probably my least favorite song of the album, I think. But, I mean, I've had no time with it. That's probably one of those songs I'm gonna need 8 or 9 listens with before I can even kind of get behind, as much as I'm behind some of these other songs already, like The Show. Some fantastic vocals. I thought that was gonna be like an upbeat song with some drums. And I think because I was expecting that, that song didn't hit for me just for that reason. I'm gonna give it a 6.5 out of 10 first listen. Do not attack me. I swear to God, I'm gonna keep listening to it. And you can check out my written review in the comment section below on albumoftheyear.org. And I promise you, it will not be a 6.5 when I actually review it. Okay, track number 10, final song of the album, Must Be Love. I'm a specialist at overthinking everything. Sounds like the beginning of Heaven. I like that. I got a first degree. Yeah, this song is Heaven's cousin, for sure. I mean, they're on the same album, so we were bound to have a couple of songs like this. Keep it simple and follow my heart. Here we go. Come on. Okay, nope, he trolled me. I really didn't. Okay. On the edge of my seat right now. When's it gonna drop? Okay, here we go. I haven't said anything about the bass line in this song. It's honestly probably my favorite part. Okay, holy crap, yeah, these headphones were getting painful to wear. His fandom is not going to survive this. Like, what are they going to do when he goes on tour and he plays most of these songs, if not all of them? Whichever songs I was talking the least during are probably the songs I like the most. As far as other One Direction members go, I will not be surprised if that ends up as my favorite solo album from a One Direction member. It's 3:30 in the morning and I was just listening to the new Niall album. What a good time. Let me know what else you guys want to see me react to. I'm sorry if my hair was a travesty the entire video. I'm sorry for sounding the way I sound this entire video. Like I said, it's 3:30 in the morning. If you're still watching, God bless you. I mean, first of all, what are you doing with your life? But I do appreciate you. And I'll see you all soon for an album that maybe one of you wants to see. You can leave in the comment section below. Bye-bye.